Winning the Google game requires a keyword strategy and content, and lots of it. So many SEO tools focus on strategy, but how do you make the content actually work for you? In this tutorial, I'll walk you through Semrush's content marketing toolset from A to Z, so you know how to generate topic ideas, structure your content, and check your articles actually deliver the SEO result you want. Let's dive in. We've partnered with Semrush to get you a special 14-day trial of Semrush Guru. So to get it, head to the following website. You can click on the card in the top right, or you can click the link in the description below. From the homepage, click on Try It Free to get started. Then you can start your trial by entering your email and your password and then clicking the Create Account button. Semrush will ask you a few other questions and then you'll land on the homepage. I'll see you over there. So here at David's Donut Den, we are launching a new store in the Seattle, Washington area. We have to compete with the existing donut shops there. And for us, that means when anyone searches for donuts, we show up higher on Google than they do. Let's see how Semrush can help. So step one is to examine what keywords our competitors rank for. To do that, we'll use Semrush's organic research tool. Now we know one of our biggest competitors is Top Pot Donuts. So I'll type in their URL, toppotdonuts.com, and then click the search button to reveal the keywords that they rank for. There's a lot of information on this page, but let's scroll down to what we're focused on, keywords. Now, it's not too surprising that the top keywords that these guys rank for are Top Pot Donuts. So let's look at all the keywords that they rank for and see if there's any opportunities for us. Now, Semrush has presented this table of 3,600 keywords, but before we filter this down, let me take you through the information we have for each keyword. Let's start with intent. Intent is search intent, and there are four types that Semrush categorizes. N for navigational means that the user is searching for a specific site. I for informational means that the user is searching for information or to answer a question. C for commercial means that the user is researching a specific product or service. And T for transactional means the user has intent to buy. Position is where this website appears on the search result page. SF or SERP features details what else shows up for this search result besides a link. Examples for the keyword Top Pot Donuts include site links, reviews, images, videos, X carousels, knowledge panel, and so on. Okay, pay attention to these next three because they can be kind of confusing. Traffic counts the average number of monthly visits to this URL from users searching for this keyword. Volume, on the other hand, tracks the average number of monthly searches for this keyword. Traffic percentage is not a click-through rate. It's the percentage of traffic that this URL receives from this keyword search compared to the total traffic that this URL receives. In other words, 22% of the total traffic going to toppotdonuts.com comes from Google search results for the keyword Top Pot Donuts. Last but not least is keyword difficulty percentage. And this is a proprietary metric from Semrush. It's measured on a scale from 0 to 100%. The higher the percentage, the harder it will be to rank organically for this keyword. The idea is when you're just starting out, target the lower percentages as they're going to be easier to rank for. Let's filter this list down because we're not going to rank for Top Pot Donuts. Up above, I'll click on Advanced Filters, and I want to get rid of any keywords, including the words Top Pot. So first, I'll change this include to an exclude, and I'll type in top here. Then I'll add another condition where I'll also change include to exclude, and then I'll add pot as the second keyword to exclude. Then let's click Apply to make the changes. Now this is starting to look better. Let's next filter the keyword difficulty down to the easy keywords only. To do that, open up the keyword difficulty filter and then enter a custom range from 0% to 30%. As you see, these are what the very easy and easy keywords go for. Then click apply. Finally, let's sort this by volume so we know the most searched keywords. Time to go through the list. What have we got? I'm going to keep track of the good ones and I recommend that you do too. First up is Best Donuts Near Me. It's got really good volume and it definitely applies to us. So let's log it. Pink Box Donuts, that's a different brand. Feather Boa, we don't sell those. Vegan Muffins, don't sell those. We don't do custom donuts. Donut Sign, probably not for us. Donut Holes Near Me, this sounds good too. So let's log it.
donut holes near me. The next one, apple fritter near me, also makes sense. Coffee donuts, also a good one. Best donut shop near me. I hope you get the idea. And now that we've selected some keywords, we need to figure out how to write content about them. This is where Semrush's next tool, the Keyword Strategy Builder, comes into play. I'm going to move this list off to the side for now. We'll come back to it later. And then scroll up until on the left side, you see Keyword Strategy Builder. Click on that link to enter the tool. Now, before I tell you what this does, let's get those keywords back from earlier. We're going to use these keywords as seed keywords to generate an entire content strategy. So if you're following along, you can copy these keywords and then paste them in the box that says enter seed keywords. Now the keyword strategy builder recognizes that you don't just want to rank for these keywords. You want to rank for all related keywords too. So when I click create list, the keyword strategy builder is going to go out to Semrush's database, search for all the related keywords to these five seed keywords, and then suggest a list of pages and subpages that I should write to bring in the maximum amount of traffic. So let's click create list. Now, this is going to take some time. You see, it's going to take maybe up to 15 minutes. So I will see you in a little bit. Okay, we are back and Semrush has found over 3,500 related keywords with a total monthly search volume of almost 3 million. We also have this bubble diagram below, which helps us optimize our content for all of these keywords. Let me show you how it works. So your content for these keywords is clustered into topics. And each of these groups of bubbles represents a topic. Each topic has a representative pillar page, which most keywords cluster around, and then subpages that logically relate to that pillar page. We can see we've got 10 total topics here, so let's investigate what Semrush has suggested. Scrolling past the topical overview bubble diagram, we can see each of the topics. As I mentioned, each topic has a representative pillar page and subpages associated with it. Let's click collapse all topics to compare them. Now looking through this list, we can compare topics based on their total search volume and their average keyword difficulty. Remember that a keyword difficulty below 30% was considered easy, and between 30 and 50% was considered possible. The first topic, which looks really enticing, is this fresh donuts topic with a search volume of almost 1.5 million and an easy keyword difficulty. Let's check this out. When we expand the topic, we immediately see the pillar page and several subpages to create. Let's try to spot check this quickly. Now this pillar page, Donuts Bakery, sounds a bit vague, so let's click on it to inspect the keywords that Semrush has grouped into this page. In addition to the keywords, you can also see the sites which rank highly for these keywords. Let's collapse this pillar page and look at some of the subpages. As we look through the list, we can see other brands, other locations, Washington, D.C., Boston, Dallas. Really only a couple of terms here. Best homemade donuts near me, free donuts today near me, although that's not going to be much help for the business. Baseball donuts near me. Let's click on show more to look at what else Semrush has. And here we see Yum Yum Donuts, Donuts Nashville, Arizona Donuts, Donuts Austin. It's looking like this is not the right topic to invest in. So let's collapse this topic and look for another one with a higher opportunity. Next up is specific donut types, so let's expand that. Now we're starting to get some interesting ideas. Filled donuts near me, protein donuts near me, bacon donuts near me, pumpkin donuts, free donuts, halal donuts. Notice also some of these markers like high relevance, where a page matches some of the seed keywords we provided originally, and high potential, like this one up top, where the page has high ranking potential because the keyword difficulty is so low and has good search volume. Now you can keep looking at all of these pages and subpages and find things that might work for you, but at some point you gotta write some content. I'm sure you've seen this button on the right-hand side called Write Content. So let's click it and see what we can do for the Filled Donuts Near Me page. Here we have two options to write our articles. The first one is Content Shake AI. This is a Semrush app to automate writing your articles in your brand voice. We'll cover this one in another video. On the other hand, the SEO Writing Assistant makes sure that the articles you write will bring in the traffic that you want. Let's select the Writing Assistant and then click Apply. Next, we need to choose, do we want SEO insights for desktop readers or phone readers. Let's stick with desktop and then click Send Keywords to open the Writing Assistant. With this pane on the left, you can start writing your article, or you can paste in an article you've already written and refine it. I have an existing article that I need some guidance on, so I'll paste it in here. Immediately on the right-hand side, you see that this article gets scored on 3 out of 4 dimensions: readability, SEO, and tone of voice. Let's check out each of these and follow it up with looking at originality. So first, readability. When you scroll down, you can see the major issues. First off, you can see the readability and the number of words compared to other articles which rank highly for these keywords. Then you scroll down more and you start to see the real issues, like my title is longer than 60 characters, and that could mean it's truncated when displayed in search results. I've also got hard to read sentences and complex words, which are highlighted in purple directly in the article. Now, Semrush doesn't just tell you the issues, it also has some tools to fix those issues. For example, we've got some tough to read sentences up here, so I'm going to highlight them and then click on the Rephraser tool. With this tool, I have several options: rephrase, simplify, expand, and summarize. I'll choose simplify because I want to keep this simple to read, then click the simplify button. The Semrush AI has taken these long, complex sentences and turned them into something that is simple and easy to read. Let's click replace and close to update the original article. Next, let's check out SEO. Our score was pretty bad here, so let's scroll down and check out the issues. SEO is about using keywords, both target keywords and recommended keywords. Because we use so few of these keywords, our score was pretty low. The SEO score also tracks other issues, like adding images and alt attributes, adding links, and adding keywords in your title. Let's next look at the tone of voice score. First, Semrush evaluates the tone of voice of the article. It can be casual, neutral, or formal, as long as it's consistent throughout. You'll also get some recommendations to change some sentences if their tone differs from the overall tone of the article. Next up is originality. Semrush has tools to check for plagiarism, which will penalize you in search results. To do that, click the Check It for Free button. It'll take a minute or two. Fortunately, looks like this one is 100% original. Before we go much further, it's important to point out this article is actually incomplete. I've got a lot of information here about donuts, but I don't have a clear call to action. In fact, I usually get writer's block when it comes to sales copy, so I need some help. This is a perfect use case for the Compose tool. I can prompt the Semrush AI to write content according to my needs. After writing the prompt, you can select the text and then click the Compose button. The AI eliminates your writer's block and allows you to keep moving. I'll reject these changes for now and then show you the last tool called Ask AI. You can find the Ask AI button under the Compose button. When you click it, you can ask the Semrush AI anything. The advantage of conversing here is that this AI has all of the best practices of SEO loaded into it. So for example, I can ask, how can I make this article better? Click Ask, and then you'll get the response in the document in a few seconds. And now you have an action item list to make this article even better.
With these tools, you should be well equipped to fight back against writer's block and blank page syndrome. Remember, you now have access to an extended 14-day trial of Semrush Guru using the link in the description below. Leave us a like and consider subscribing, as it really helps us with the algorithm. I'll see you next time.